We work in a sector which is vibrant, it's innovative, it's collaborative, and I think essentially also it recognises that we can pull in knowledge and experience from adjacent sciences, pulling on UK's strength in the life sciences and remote sensing, for example. The strategy is to stimulate innovation within the sector, bringing up new developments from small, medium-sized enterprises, introducing that to the best of thinking in UK academia, and marrying that to the needs, current and future, of industry, so that we can work towards a common goal in terms of improving food security and strengthening the UK's position within the global food sector. The Big Data Centre is bringing together different data sets from different organisations, open data that in itself won't provide innovation to the UK, to farmers overseas. But when we blend it together, we can start to see the linkages between all of what the data are telling us. And we can prepare that and analyse it and give feedback to the UK farming community, to industrial sectors, so that we can begin to see insights and forecast what's going to be happening in the future, so that we can prepare for tomorrow's threats as well as deal with today's. The Big Data Centre can encourage investment in the UK by providing a hub, a central port of experience, where companies work from overseas can draw down upon this collaborative effort within the UK. It will provide an investment opportunity because the UK government and industry is being seen to come together to treat the analysis of agriculture seriously in terms of how we provide a sustainable and intensified yield from UK and overseas farms, drawing down on fewer resources but producing more food.